Hey guys, Kevin here, and one of the best games from last year, The Wolf Among Us, has finally returned with its second episode called Smoke and Mirrors. The story picks up mere hours after the grim ending of the previous episode, where after a brief chat with the local normal police, Bigby Wolf continues his investigation into the Fable Killer. While there are still some great character moments in this episode, we're in pure investigation mode here. The whole episode largely consists of interrogations and sleuthing. There are still some fight scenes, but they either take a back seat or are even entirely optional. There's also less emphasis on choice this time around. While you can certainly decide how to handle interrogations, there are no big decision moments that massively impact the game. This may disappoint some, but it in no way detracts from this brilliant tale. You'll soon be finding yourself in new locations, both within the woodlands and around Fable Town itself, including the Pudding and Pie, a strip club which houses a famous dancer. Now, I don't want to give away too much in this review, but let's just say that fans of a certain Disney film are in for a bit of a shock. Speaking of new characters, we're finally introduced to the morally questionable Bluebeard, voiced by Lee Everett himself, David Fennoy, who clearly has a larger role to play in the story, but for now only has one scene. The story has great drive to it this time around. There's no downtime for exposition like in the previous episode. You simply get on with the investigation with terrific pacing. My only real complaint is with the ending, which, while still a great cliffhanger, is incredibly sudden and comes out of nowhere. Telltale are usually masters at making each episode feel like its own contained story, with a beginning, middle and an end, while still feeling part of a larger, cohesive narrative. Though much like the last episode of The Walking Dead, you'll just be getting into the tale when suddenly it ends. I found myself throwing my hands up in the air and screaming, "No!" when the screen suddenly cut to black. It's also a little bit on the short side, coming in at just under 2 hours. While I don't usually bemoan the length of episodes, it does feel as if something is missing from the ending. These complaints aside though, this is still a great ride. The presentation is fantastic, dare I even say better than The Walking Dead. Effective lighting, great voice acting, and terrific music really brings this world to life. There is the occasional shaky animation and mismatched lip sync, but nothing worth getting hung up over. Even after completing the episode, you can go back and look at the Book of Fables, which is great for fans like me who just want to learn more about this fascinating world. We here at Bloody Disgusting are big fans of Telltale games, and are glad to see they don't seem to be letting up. I'll be giving this episode an 8 out of 10. I really want to score it higher, but it does feel as if something is missing from the final act of this episode. What's on offer is still intriguing stuff though, and I lost count of the number of times my jaw hit the floor. Just please, Telltale Games, don't take so long next time. I need more. Like, comment, subscribe, kill, maim, murder, share, Facebook, tweet, kill, murder. You know the drill. Could you do all that, please? Oh, and thanks for watching. It means something. It means a view. Thanks for the view.